सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरा। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। शांति शांति शांति। सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृग्यत्तु निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत भेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्तोऽन्यदिति मे निश्चिता। So we were seeing the Tippani on the sentence occurring in the 225th Avarta. And that was Antakrana Vrittihi Yada Brahmakara Bhavati Tada Sa Vrittihi Na Bahihi Gachati Kintu Sharirasya Antaheva Vartate Taya Vrittya Saha Brahmanaha Sambandha Asti तस्मात् ब्रह्मज्ञानमपि सुख दुखादि ज्ञानमिव प्रत्यक्ष रूपं भवति। सो शिष्य हैड आस्क्ड दिस क्वेश्चन दैट हाउ कैन वी हैव डायरेक्ट नॉलेज ऑफ ब्रह्म बिकॉज डायरेक्ट नॉलेज इज अटेन्ड बाय इंद्रिय संबंध एंड फॉर ब्रह्मन इंद्रिय संबंध इज नॉट पॉसिबल देयरफॉर हाउ कैन वी हैव डायरेक्ट नॉलेज एंड यू हैव टोल्ड that paroksha gnanam of brahman will not give moksha so aparoksha gnanam I want because that alone is the means for moksha so how aparoksha gnanam otherwise called pratyaksha gnanam will be possible for brahman with regard to brahman for that so much discussion took place and acharya said that your thinking about the pratyaksha is very narrow thinking You are thinking that when Indriya Sambandha is there with the object, then only the Pratyaksha Gnanam happens. Acharya said that is one of the situations. Yes, when Indriya Sambandha is there with the object, the knowledge taking place is Pratyaksha. But that is not the only Pratyaksha. That is called Indriya Pratyaksha. Second is Shabda Pratyaksha. Third is called Sakshi Pratyaksha. And here the Brahma Jnanam is Shabda Pratyaksha. And how it happens, that was said that when Upadesha is there, then Antakrana Vrutti is there, Brahmakara Vrutti, that does not go outside, it is there inside the body. And that Vrutti has got Sambandha with Brahman. And that Vrutti, he becomes the Avrana Nivarika, and because of that, Brahma Jnanam is available. Means there is a claiming that I am Brahman. Means Avarana about the Brahma Swarupa of Atma is removed. And that particular idea is explained with an example which is a very unique example. The example is given in the Tippani. Chakshosuryo Ajayata Adityas Chakshur Bhutva Akshini Pravishat Ityadi Pramanena Chakshusi Surya Bheda Asti. In Chakshu, Chakshur Indriya, there is a Surya Bheda, non-difference with the sun. Generally, we talk about the three division, Adhyatma, Adidevata and Adibhuta. But here we need not go for that, only Vyashti and Samashti, where Adidevata, Adibhuta are combined. So there is only one principle, we can call it Prakasha Tattvam, has got two aspects or two versions. One is Adhyatma, individual, Vyashti, other is Samashti. So Prakasha Tattvam is available in the Chakshu, Chakshur Indriya with Vyashti Upadhi. And the same prakasha is available as samashti with the upadhi of this total universe. So vyashti prakasha, samashti prakasha. Samashti prakasha is referred to by the word surya. So surya is samashti prakasha and chakshu is vyashti prakasha. Therefore the chakshu si surya bheda asti. And for that he gave the pramanam. And what is the pramanam? That from chakshu surya is born, from the virat purusha, the chakshu of the virat purusha, surya ajayata, surya is born. So surya, the samashti surya is born, and from that surya, or that surya alone has entered into the eyes as chakshurindriya, based on the aitariya upadishad. And then between this vyashti adhyatma chakshu and samashti surya, there is abheda. But that abheda is veiled by the anguliyadi avarana. And that is a very unique way of seeing that when there is anguliyadi, then this samashti surya prakasha is not seen by us. So anguliyadi rupa alpavarana avaranena surya tirodhane. When there is a veiling of the sun by the avarana, which is a very small in the palm of a finger, brahmandantarvarti suryasya prakashah na drishyate. So that time, the prakasha which is obtaining in the entire world is not seen. When you are having this finger, then you will not be seeing the prakasha which is all over. Avarana nivrutto. When anguli rupa avarana is removed, then chakshurantargata antakrana vrutya brahmandantarvarti suryasya prakashah drishyate. Then prakasha of the sun which is obtaining all over. So we should not consider surya to be limited only in solar disk. We should see as a samashti prakasha. The surya prakasha of the sun is seen by the antakrana vritti, which is obtaining in the eye. So what has happened that the vyashti prakasha and samashti prakasha have become one. And therefore chakshurgata antakrana vritti is able to appreciate the samashti prakasha. So when the avarana of the oneness between the vyashti and samashti is removed, then samashti is appreciated. That is the drashtanta amsha. And now he is applying to the sakshi and this brahman. Evam eva sakshi rupe atmani brahmana abheda asti. Sakshi, which is called pratyagatma vampada lakshartha, in that we brahmana abheda, there is oneness with the brahman. And tasya antakarana, tasya means bheda, abhedasya. Brahmana abheda asti kasmin sakshi rupi atmani. And now abhedasya antakranagata agdamnamsha rupa svalpavaranena achadane sarvatra paripurnam brahmana pratyakshataya basata. In the drashtanta, avarana was in the form of anguli, the fingers. Here avarana is agdana. And this by avarana of the avidya, which is manifesting in the antakarana, because of that avaranamsha of the agdanam, this sarvatra paripurnam brahma na drishyate. Just as the sunlight which is pervading all over was not seen when the avarana was there, similarly brahman which is all over is not understood, is not pratyakshataya bhasate, is not appreciated directly. So angulisthaniya avaranam is there in the case of this abheda between the sakshi and brahma. The avaranam, which is the avarana shakti of the agdanam, is veiling the non-difference between sakshi and brahma. And because of that, I am and I shine, that knowledge is there. But brahman alone is and brahman is shining everywhere, that knowledge is not there. And now yada sharirantar jayamana brahmatma bhedakara vrutya purvokta avaranasya bhangaha jayate. When avarana, which is there, avaranam, the veil, avaranam is veiling factor, which is veiling the oneness between the atma and brahma, when that avarana is removed, then sarvatra paripurna brahmanaha svaprakashatva rupena bhanam bhavati. Then there is appreciation of परिपूर्ण लिमिटलेस ब्रह्मन एवरीवेयर एंड फॉर दैट ही गेव द एग्जांपल गृहांतरगतस्य आकाशस्य असंगत्वादि ज्ञानेन आई नो दैट द स्पेस अबटेनिंग इन द हाउस इज असंग एंड आई हैव द नॉलेज दैट द स्पेस अबटेनिंग इन द हाउस is one with the space obtaining everywhere. Then, when I have knowledge of the asangatva of the grihakasha, then I will have knowledge of the asangatva of mahakasha as well. So, I don't have to have separate knowledge of mahakasha being asanga when I have got this twofold knowledge. One knowledge is grihakasha is asanga, other knowledge is grihakasha and mahakasha are one. When these two are there, then mahakasha is asanga wherever I see space outside the room that also is asanga I don't need any separate attempt similarly what he gives two example for conveying this idea one akasha gave example and he gave other example of a chakshu surya abheda and similarly once I understand that I am Sat Swarupa, Chit Swarupa, and I Sat Swarupa, Chit Swarupa am one with Brahman, then same Sat Swarupa, Chit Swarupa, Brahman will be appreciated in all objects, in all situations. That is what is said here, Sarvatra Paripurna Brahmanaha Swaprakashatva Rupena Bhanam Bhavati. As we have, yesterday we saw that in every perception, Ghatadi Gnanam, Asti Bhati, He is Brahma Rupam and therefore you don't require a separate vritti for illumining the asti and bhati. You require only vritti for illumining the nama rupa. And asti bhati Brahman is obtaining in every cognition, in every object, that particular appreciation happens to the person who has got this abheda jnanam. And that was said here, Paripurna Brahmanaha Swaprakashatva Rupena Bhadam Bhavati. I am existence, I am consciousness, same existence, consciousness is available in every cognition. That type of appreciation happens to the person. So this tippani is given to show that how the vritti which is obtaining in the body will have sambandha with Brahma. Sambandha with Brahma can be said because Brahman is available as Sakshi. So I appreciate myself to be Sakshi free from any limitations. That appreciation itself is figuratively called the Sambandha of the Vritti with Brahman. It is a figurative expression and second Tippani will make it clear. So it is not that the Vritti can have the real Sambandha with the Brahman. But when I am appreciating Atma to be free from limitations, and free from limitations is called Brahma. Therefore, seeing myself to be free from limitations is figuratively called Sambandha of the Vritti with Brahma. Seeing myself to be free from limitations is figuratively called to be this Sambandha of Vritti with Brahma. That is said here. And so this tippani is just to show that how Shariranthara Vritti can have Sambandha with Brahman. Alright. Then second tippani we were seeing that Brahman is na Sakshi Bhasyam. Many people think Brahman also is Sakshi Bhasyam, everything is Sakshi Bhasyam, so Brahman also is Sakshi Bhasyam. Brahman is not Sakshi Bhasyam. And why Brahman is not Sakshi Bhasyam? This Moola Grantha also, it was told. That Brahman is not illumined like Sukha Dukkhadi. Sukha Dukkhadi is Sakshi Bhasyam. Why? Because Sukha Dukkhadi are known through the vrittis which are obtaining inside without any involvement of the organs or Shabda. Shabda or Indriya Sambandha Vina, there is appreciation of Sukha Dukkhadi. Therefore, they are called Sakshi Bhasya. Whereas, the Brahman is not revealed like that. In revelation of Brahma, Shabda Pramanam is used and therefore it cannot be compared with the Sukha Dukkhadi. Therefore, Brahman is not Sakshi Bhasya. And then somebody may have this doubt, if Brahman is not Sakshi Bhasyam, then it can be Pramatru Bhasya or Pramatru Gochara. So that possibility is dismissed in the second Tippani. Yatha Brahmana Sakshi Bhasya Tatha चिदाभास सहित अंतःकरण वृत्ति रूप प्रमातुः अपि अगोचरं भवति। हियर अंतःकरण रूप प्रमातु, दैट इज ए बेटर एक्सप्रेशन। सो ब्रह्म इज नॉट साक्षी भाष्य, सिमिलरली ब्रह्मन इज नॉट प्रमात्रु विषय आल्सो। वाई? जनरल प्रिंसिपल इज एनी ऑब्जेक्ट विल बी कॉल्ड प्रमात्रु विषय ओनली व्हेन देयर इज अ वृत्ति व्याप्ति एंड फल व्याप्ति। सो इन एनी नॉलेज वेर वृत्ति व्याप्ति एंड फल व्याप्ति इज देयर, दैट ऑब्जेक्ट इज सेड टू बी प्रमात्रु गोचर। Brahman is not like that, and therefore Brahma is not pramatru gochara. That idea is explained. Deepantara peksham bina kevala netrasya yatha deepaha vishaya bhavati tatha brahma kevalayaha aham brahma smiti brahmakara antakrana vruttehe vishayatam pratipadyate. Just as the lamp becomes the object of mere netra without expecting any lamp, another lamp, tatha similarly brahma केवलायाः अंतःकरण वृत्तेः विषयतां प्रतिपद्यते। सो ब्रह्मन अटेन्स द स्टेटस ऑफ बीइंग द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ अंतःकरण वृत्ति विच इज ब्रह्माकार। एंड ब्रह्माकार अंतःकरण वृत्ति मीन्स व्हाट? अहम् ब्रह्मास्मि, अहम् ब्रह्मास्मि, आई एम ब्रह्म, दिस इज कॉल्ड ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति। दिस टाइप ऑफ अप्रिसिएशन इज कॉल्ड ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति। एंड ब्रह्म प्रतिपद्यते अटेन्स द स्टेटस ऑफ बीइंग द ऑब्जेक्ट of such vritti. And Brahman has got the vishayata of this vritti, that also is a figurative expression. That will be clarified by the Tippanikara later on. Here the significance of kevalayaha is only antakrana vritti. What is the significance? That chidabhasa is not required. And that is conveyed by the word kevalayaha. Tasmat kevalayaha means chidabhasa rahitayaha. Chidabhasa is that, but Chidabhasa does not have any job to do, and therefore Kevalayaha. So without the involvement of, or without the requirement of Chidabhasa, this Brahman becomes the object of Antakrana Mukti. Tasmat, therefore, Brahma na Pramatru Bhasyam Api. Therefore, Brahman is not objectified by Pramata. So here what is clarified? That Brahman is not Sakshi Bhasya and Brahman is not Pramatru Bhasya also. Why? Because Pramatru Bhasyam is that which is objectified by the Vritti and which is objectified by Chidabhasa, illumined by Chidabhasa. And that status is not there in Brahma, therefore Brahman is not Pramatru Bhasya. Kintu, then what is the status of Brahma? Svaprakasham prati अन्य प्रकाश अपेक्षा रहित सर्वावभासक स्वयं प्रकाश प्रकाश स्वरूपम ब्रह्म। बट ब्रह्मन इज सेल्फ एविडेंट, स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूप मीन्स ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ बीइंग सेल्फ एविडेंट, सेल्फ प्रेजेंट। एंड द स्वयं प्रकाश स्वरूप इज एक्सप्लेन बाय दिस ग्रंथकार एट द टिप्पणीकार। स्वप्रकाशम प्रति फॉर इट्स रेवलेशन अन्य प्रकाश अपेक्षा रहित, one who is devoid of the expectancy of the light, other light. So for revelation of oneself, Brahman is free from any expectancy of other light, and itself is sarvavabhasaka, it is illumining all. See, that is the definition of svayam prakasha. Anyavabhasakatve sati anyabhasyatvam svaprakashatvam. So that which is illumining all but not illumined by anyone. Sarvava bhasakatve sati anya bhasyatvam, not being illumined by anyone, that is called svaprakasha. So that which illumines all and that which is not illumined by anyone, that is svayam prakasha. And here technically we say that sarvava bhasakatvam is in the sense of sarvava bhasakatva yogyatvam. Why we say that? Because it is not necessary that Brahman will be illumining all the time. So when it is not illumining, it is not become Swaprakasha. So we say Swaprakasha Yogyatvam. Even though Swaprakashatvam is not there, but Swaprakasha Yogyatvam is there. Like with this person is a driver. It doesn't mean he is driving now, but driving Yogyatvam is there. Therefore we call it is driver. Otherwise, one who drives is called driver. So, he is not driving now. So then, why is he called driver? Yogyatva. So, similarly, Anya avabhasakatva yogyatve sati anya bhasyatvam. That which is not illumined by anyone. That is called Swaprakasha. In Chitsikudyatta, so many options are given. What is Swayam Prakashatvam? About 11 options are given. And finally, some lakshana similar to this is given. Okay. So, Swayam Prakasham means that which illumines all, but not illumined by anyone. That is called Swayam Prakasha. And here, Swayam Prakasha or Swaprakasha, one wrong understanding people generally carry is that which illumines itself. That is Swaprakasha. That is not correct definition. In Keno Upanishad, this was dismissed. If you say that this Brahman is illumining itself, then the Kartru Karma Virodha will come. There only Kartru Karma Virodha will come. So, Swaprakasha does not mean that which illumines itself. That's what people think. Swaprakasha means science itself illumines itself. No. Illumining itself is not the Lakshana. That which does not require any illumination or its revelation, that is called Swaprakasha. So, Brahman is Swaprakasha. All right. If Brahman is Swaprakasha, then why do we require this vritti also? Self-effulgent. Then he said, even though it is Swaprakasha, still it requires illumination. And for that, we can give this example. Even though this lamp is self-effulgent, still it requires chakshu. Why? Because it has got some type of avaranam. And that avaranam is removed by the chakshu or chakshugata antakrana vritti. Similarly, for Brahman also, even though it is self-effulgent, it has got some avaranam, and for that avarana nivritti, vritti is required. That is discussed here. Malena malam hanyat iti nyayena vritti hi brahmana avarana bhangam karoti. He said, Malena malam hanyat. Another nyaya is kantakena kantakam. You heard this? Kantakena kantakam. A thorn is removed by the thorn. Similarly, malena malam hanyat. The impurity is removed by impurity. Like soap we apply for removing this dirt. Iti nyayena, following this logic, vritti hi brahmana avarana bhangam karoti. Vritti does the removal of the veiling of Brahman. Alright. Here, this vritti is also considered to be malasthaniya. Malena malam. So, vritti, vrittya, malena, malam, avaranam. Hanyat. So, why vritti is called malam? Because vritti also is avidya karya. Vritti is the product of the antakrana, and antakrana is the product of avidya. Therefore, antakrana vritti is called malam. And see, but in Mandukya Upanishad, this Brahmagdhanam is equated to Chaitanyam. If you remember, Brahmagdhanam is equated to Chaitanyam. Brahmagdhanam is Brahma Rupam, Ajena Ajam. So, there is a confusion that some places said that Brahmagdhanam is Anityam and here it is called this Vritti is the Mala. So, we say that Brahmagdhanam has two aspects. One is Vritti aspect, other is the Chaitanya Swarupa aspect. From this angle of Chaitanya Swarupa, it is called Ajam, Nityam, Brahma Swarupam. And from the Vritti aspect, it is called Anityam and Mala. Not knowing this difference, people get confused. Because someplace Swamiji, you are telling that Brahmagnanam also is Anityam. One person in Bangalore, he was very much disturbed when I say Brahmagnanam is Anityam. Swamiji, Brahmagnanam, how can it be Anityam? So, Brahmagnanam is, every Gnanam is Anityam. Brahmagnanam is Anityam from the standpoint of Vritti. Brahmagnanam is Nityam from the standpoint of Chaitanya. And this is not only for this. But applicable to all jnana. But with reference to Brahmagnanam, we say like this because in Brahmagnanam, all the vrittis and all the kriya karaka phala veda is negated. Therefore, Brahmagnanam has got little special status in terms of being Brahma Swarupa. Like we say, no, Guru Brahma. So, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru is, why said Guru is Parabrahma? Everybody is Param Brahma, but Guru is called Param Brahma. Why? because the guru has discovered this path. Similarly, in Brahmajnanam, all kartru, karana, karma, all bhedas are dissolved. Therefore, it is equated to me. Alright. Soyam vritti prayuktavrana bhanga eva vrittya brahmanaha vishayikaranam uchyate. See, it makes a very important clarification. What do we mean by Brahma being objectified by vritti? Because earlier also it was said, Brahma vrittehe vishayatam pratipadyate. So how can you say, we have been told that Brahman is not objectifiable and all this. Jor jor se bolte. So you are telling very loudly, Brahman is unobjectifiable, achintyam, etc. And now you said Brahman is the vishaya of the vritti. So he said Brahma is the vishaya of the vritti in secondary sense. Therefore he says, soyam vritti prayukta avrana bhangaha eva. This removal of the veiling caused by the vritti alone is called vritya brahmanaha vishayikaranam. Objectification of Brahma by vritti is nothing but the removal of the avarana by vritti. So it is a figurative expression. It is not that in primary sense the Brahman is becoming the object. Na prakarantarena vritya brahmana vishayikaranam sambhavati. By any other method, the objectification of Brahma by vritti is not possible. Only in this sense, that when this brahmakara vritti, aham brahma, that knowledge is born, then the avranam goes away. And generally, when the vishayakara vritti takes place, then vishaya vishayaka ajnanam goes away. Therefore, we say that Brahman is the object of the vritti. When gata vishayaka vritti is born, then gata vishayaka ajnanam goes away. So here Brahma vishayaka ajnanam goes away. And goes away by what? By aham brahmasmi ajnanam. Therefore aham brahmasmi ajnanam must be Brahma vishayaka. That roundabout we bring. Alright. Sakshi. Bahya sadhana peksham vina eva aham brahmasmiti vritti rupam tatva ajnanam prakashit. And one more point he brings in. That is, Sakshi prakashayati is illumining what? Aham brahmasmiti vritti rupam tatvagdhanam. The knowledge of reality, tatvagdhanam, which is in the form of vritti, a thought. What type of thought? Aham brahmasmi. I am Brahma. I am Brahma. This knowledge is illumined by Sakshi. Sakshi prakashayati. Bahya sadhana peksham vina eva. Without expecting any external means in the form of these indriyas or even shabda. Ataha eva. Therefore, tatva jnanam, the knowledge of Brahman is Sakshi Bhasya. Knowledge of the Brahman is Sakshi Bhasya miti abhidhiyate. It is called illumined by Sakshi. So, what is the distinction made? Brahman is not Sakshi Bhasya, but Brahma jnanam is Sakshi Bhasya. That is the difference. Alright. So we had seen that finally the teacher concluded that Brahma Jnanam is Pratyaksha Jnanam. Why? Because the criterion for deciding the Jnanam to be Pratyaksha is what? Yatra Vrityasaha Vishayasya Sambandha Tatra Pratyaksha Jnanam. And here Vritti, Brahmakara Vritti has got the Sambandha with Brahma. Therefore Brahma Jnanam is Pratyaksha Jnanam, otherwise called Aparoksha Jnanam. If Pratyaksha and Aparoksha are used in this text in the sense of synonyms, both are synonyms, Pratyaksha and Aparoksha. In Panchadashi we make the division. Panchadashi they say that the knowledge of fire is Paroksha Jnanam, from the smoke. Then the knowledge of Bhattapatadi which are there in front is Pratyaksha Jnanam. And knowledge regarding myself is Aparoksha Jnanam. That is division there. But here the Pratyaksha and Aparoksha are synonyms. Alright. So this, by the grace of the Guru, this Tattva Drashti got the knowledge. Aham Brahmasmi iti vruttau niravaranam Brahma bhati. Tattva Drashti eva muvacha. Up to this we had seen. The shloka is to be seen. एक्सप्रेसिंग हिज सेटिस्फैक्शन, निरावरण निर्भासम अहम ब्रह्मेति बुद्धवान श्री सद्गुरु प्रसादेन यखंडाकार वृत्तितः। ही सेज अहम ब्रह्म, आई एम ब्रह्म इति बुद्धवान, आई हैव अंडरस्टूड। एट व्हाट टाइप ऑफ ब्रह्म? निरावरणम, फ्री फ्रॉम एनी आवरण। निर्भासम मीन्स शाइनिंग, निशेषेण भासते इति निर्भासम, दैट विच इज शाइनिंग कंप्लीटली। निरावरणम निर्भासम अहम ब्रह्म। एंड निरावरणम इज यूज टू इंडिकेट दैट आवरणम ऑन दी ब्रह्मन विच वॉज देयर इज रिमूव्ड, देयरफॉर निरावरणम। एंड निर्भासम इज द स्वरूप ऑफ ब्रह्मन। सो निरावरणम इंडिकेट्स दैट आवरण इज रिमूव्ड बाय द ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति। सो आई एम निरावरण निर्भासम ब्रह्म। सो निरावरण वर्ड कैन बी यूज इन टू वेज। फ्रॉम द स्टैंड पॉइंट ऑफ ब्रह्मन, आवरणम इज नॉट देयर। देयरफॉर इवन फॉर अज्ञानी ब्रह्मन इज ऑलवेज निरावरण, बिकॉज फ्रॉम द स्टैंड पॉइंट ऑफ ब्रह्म आवरण डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट। सो ब्रह्म दृष्ट्या ब्रह्म सर्वदा निरावरणमेव। बट अज्ञानी दृष्ट्या, सिंस अज्ञानम इज देयर, साधक दृष्ट्या अज्ञानम इज देयर, देयरफॉर ही सेड आई एम ब्रह्मन, बट माय बीइंग ब्रह्मन इज कवर्ड एज इट वर, और वाज कवर्ड एटलीस्ट। सो अज्ञानी दृष्ट्या द ब्रह्मन इज सावरण निरावरण। सो हियर बोथ वेज इज निरावरण इन केस ऑफ दिस तत्व दृष्टि। निरावरणम निर्भासम अहम ब्रह्मेति बुद्धवान श्री सद्गुरु हो प्रसादेन, बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ द सद्गुरु, ग्लोरियस सद्गुरु। ही अखंडाकार वृत्तितः, एंड इंडीड बाय अखंडाकार वृत्ति, ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति। ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति इज कॉल्ड अखंडाकार बिकॉज इन दैट सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट डिविजन इज नॉट देयर। इन अदर वृत्ति वेन से अहम घटम पश्यामी, देर इज सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट डिविजन। हियर सब्जेक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट डिविजन इज नॉट देर, फॉर अखंडाकार वृत्तितः अहम ब्रह्म इति बुद्धवान, आई हैव अंडरस्टूड। सो विद दिस देव इति श्री वासुदेव ब्रह्मेन्द्र सरस्वती विरचिते विचार सागरे उत्तमाधिकारिणम उपदेश निरूपणम नाम चतुर्थ तरंग, फोर्थ तरंग इज कंप्लीटेड। And yeah, we have to take one more footnote, that where the division of the adhikari is given. Who is Uttama adhikari? He said, Yasya antakranam purva punya paripaka vashad atyantam shuddham asti. A person whose mind is very pure because of the purva punya paripaka, because of the fructification of the punyam person has done in the previous janma. And yasya गुरुपदिष्ट महावाक्य रूप शब्द प्रमाणेन सुदृढ़ बोध जाता। द पर्सन टू हुम द वेरी फर्म नॉलेज इज बॉर्न बाय द शब्द प्रमाणम इन द फॉर्म ऑफ महावाक्य विच इज टॉट बाय द टीचर। सो इट इज लाइक यू नो द फलबल कल्प्य, ए पर्सन हु गेट्स द नॉलेज बाय द गुरुपदेश without requiring any manana nidhi dhyasanam, that person is uttamadhikari. So a person whose mind is very pure and a person to whom this very firm knowledge is born out of pramanam in the form of mahavakya taught by the teacher, and yasya cha tadrisa sudrada bodho dayanantaram samshayadi nivruttaye shravanadi sadhanantaram na apekshitam स एव उत्तमाधिकारी। एंड अनदर आस्पेक्ट ऑफ उत्तमाधिकारी और अनदर क्वालिफिकेशन और द लक्षण ऑफ उत्तमाधिकारी इज यस्य च एंड फॉर हुम तादृश सुदृढ़ बोधोदयानंतरम, आफ्टर द राइज ऑफ सच फर्म नॉलेज संशयादि निवृत्तये, फॉर द रिमूवल ऑफ डाउट एटसेट्रा, श्रवणादि साधनानंतरम, आफ्टर अदर साधना श्रवण, आफ्टर दि साधन ऑफ श्रवणादि, श्रवणादि साधनांतरम न अपेक्षितम। सो अदर साधना, सॉरी अदर साधना सच एज श्रवणादि, फर्दर श्रवणादि न अपेक्षितम, श्रवण मनन निधिध्यासनम न अपेक्षितम। मीन्स ए पर्सन डज श्रवणम वंस एंड ही इज ज्ञानम इज अज्ञानम इज गॉन, नॉलेज इज वेरी फर्म एंड आफ्टरवर्ड्स रिपीटेड श्रवणम और मननम निधिध्यासनम नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, स एव उत्तमाधिकारी, दैट पर्सन इज उत्तमाधिकारी. सो थ्री थिंग्स आर टोल्ड, द पर्सन हु हैज गॉट वेरी प्योर माइंड, सेकंड द पर्सन टू हुम वेरी फर्म नॉलेज इज बॉर्न ऑन लिसनिंग टू द महावाक्योपदेश फ्रॉम गुरु, एंड अ पर्सन हु डज नॉट रिक्वायर रिपीटेड श्रवणम एंड मननम एंड निधिध्यासनम फॉर दिस रिमूवल ऑफ द डाउट्स एंड हैबिचुअल एरर, दैट पर्सन इज उत्तमाधिकारी. यस्य तु अंतःकरणं अत्यंतं शुद्धं किंतु ईषत् मल विक्षेपादि दोषयुक्तं स मध्यमाधिकारी. सो ए पर्सन हूज माइंड इज नॉट वेरी प्योर, लिटिल बिट मल एंड विक्षेपा, मल मीन्स रागद्वेषास, विक्षेपा मीन्स चित्त चांचल्यम, रेस्टलेसनेस ऑफ द माइंड, दिस डिफेक्ट्स आर देयर, दैट पर्सन इज मध्यमाधिकारी अथवा तनिष्ठाधिकारी. इनफैक्ट लिटिल बिट मोर इज देयर, देन इट इज कनिष्ठाधिकारी. सम इम्प्योरिटीज आर देयर विच आर कमिंग इन इज वे टू गेट द दृढ़ बोध, दैट पर्सन इज मध्यमा, एंड वन वॉज मोर अशुद्धि एंड मोर विक्षेपा, ही इज कनिष्ठाधिकारी. एंड महावाक्य रूप शब्दात अपरोक्ष ज्ञानोदयानंतरम अपि संशयादि निवृत्ते तेन श्रवणादि श्रवणादिकम अनुष्ठेयम्. आफ्टर लिसनिंग टू महावाक्य रूप शब्दात अपरोक्ष ज्ञानोदयानंतरम अपि, दिट इज अ वेरी पिक्युलर सिद्धांत ऑफ अवर निश्चल दास जी, दैट व्हेन यू हियर महावाक्य यू विल हैव अपरोक्ष ज्ञान. सो ही सेड आफ्टर द राइज ऑफ द डायरेक्ट नॉलेज फ्रॉम द वर्ड्स ऑफ द महावाक्य संशयादि निवृत्ते फॉर द रिमूवल ऑफ द डाउट एटसेट्रा तेना बाय दैट पर्सन श्रवणादिकम श्रवण मनन निधिध्यासनम इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी परफॉर्म्ड. इन विचार सागर इट इज सेड व्हेन अ पर्सन लिसन्स टू दिस महावाक्य फर्स्ट टाइम इवन ड्यूरिंग दिस वेद अध्ययन काले when he has got some Sanskrit knowledge and in Gurukulam after this the Veda Shabda Adhyayanam then Arthagdhanam also is given. This some what is called some super what is called preliminary understanding of the words of Vedas is given. At that time itself person gets this knowledge Aham Brahmasmi and it is Aparokshagdhanam. Therefore, everybody can claim who has listened to Mahavakya with some understanding that he knows the meanings of the words, he has got aparokshana. Then why do we do Shravanam, etc.? We do Shravanam for removing the Pramana Samshaya, we do Mananam for removing the Prameya Samshaya, we do Nididhyasanam for Viparita Bhavana. He said, you got aparokshana. So if somebody asks you, did you get aparokshana? Yes. You can jor say, you can bol say. Aparoksha gnanam ite. Only thing, if person is a madhyama adhikari, adham adhikari, he requires further shravanadi. Alright. And elsewhere we have seen that these three adhikaris, we divide in this manner. One is that a person who has got the raga, let's see, vikshepa and mala both, Mala and Vikshepa both are there. Means he has not done this Karma Yoga and Upasana. Then that person is Adhamadhikari, Kanishthadhikari. A person who has done this Karma Yoga and therefore is free from this Mala, but Vikshepa is there, is Madhyamadhikari. And a person who has done both Karma Yoga and Upasana, therefore Mala and Vikshepa both are gone, that is called Uttamadhikari. So depending upon the two impurities, one impurity, or two obstacles, one obstacle or zero obstacle. Based on that, the division is made. Alright. So, in the next class, we will see the summary of the fourth and we'll enter into the fifth chapter. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. शांति 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 हरि ओम श्री.